Welcome back to the channel. This video is a continuation of my previous DNA genetic ancestry videos, in which I showed my DNA results from different DNA companies and explained a little bit about myself. If you haven't watched those, please do so. As stated before, I'm Eritrean and my ethnicity is Tigrinya. There have been many questions about the origins of Habesha people and what race they are, so I decided to do numerous DNA ancestry tests to find out and to share my DNA results with anybody who was interested as well. In this video, I'll be briefly discussing my GEDmatch DNA results. GEDmatch is similar to Illustrative DNA in that you create an account and upload your raw DNA data to the website to receive your results. You can get your raw DNA data from one of the other DNA testing companies like 23andMe or Ancestry DNA that requires a DNA sample from you. Different DNA testing companies will have instructions on their websites of how to download your own raw DNA data. I downloaded my raw DNA data from 23andMe and uploaded it to GEDmatch. You get your results within 24 hours after uploading your raw DNA data to GEDmatch. Unlike Illustrative DNA, which requires a fee to use its services, GEDmatch is free. However, if you want access to more premium features, you have to pay. Although the free GEDmatch tools were enough for me. GEDmatch has numerous features and is more advanced than the other DNA companies I've used in the past. However, the only feature I am interested in is the Admixture Heritage tool, which provides ancient ancestry composition results. The Admixture Heritage tool on GEDmatch provides percentage breakdowns of genetic ancestry groups you are related to. There are 5 projects on GEDmatch that offer multiple admixture calculators. I have used every calculator and it is considered best to select a calculator that corresponds to your known ancestry. If you don't, you will get odd results. For example, when I use the calculator Eurogenes K12, my results appear as mainly West African and Southwest Asian. Clearly, the West African component is a mistake. The calculators on GEDmatch attempt to estimate your ancestry using a reference set of regions or genetic groups. Depending on the calculator, the reference set will be different. The Eurogenes K12 calculator does not have an East African component within the reference set. So instead, they use the next closest thing to estimate my African ancestry, which is West African. When I use the calculator Harappa World, for example, which includes both an East African and West African component, the results appear more accurate, with the majority of my African ancestry being East African. The first calculator I would recommend using for Horn Africans is Jedroja K3. It separates your Sub-Saharan African ancestry from your Eurasian ancestry in a simple manner, which for me is about 45% Sub-Saharan African and 55% Eurasian. Sub-Saharan African is vague and the calculator that best defines its ancestry in my opinion is PrintDNA LK8 African. It determined me to be around 55% Western Semitic, which acts as a non-African component but is primarily referring to Middle Eastern ancestry in my case. 27% Nilo-Saharan, which is referring to Nilotic ancestry in my case. 9% Niger-Congo, which is all the Congo results put together. 7% Emotic, which is referring to Southwestern Ethiopian ancestry. And 2% Southern Hunter-Gatherer, which is referring to the Khoisan of South Africa. These results are fairly similar to my Illustrative DNA results. The major difference comes with the addition of the Emotic ancestry, which I mentioned in my Illustrative DNA video was absent. The percentages seem to align with previous studies done on Northeast Africans, which showed them to be primarily of West Eurasian and Eastern African ancestry. The East African component being made up of Nilotic primarily and Emotic to a lesser extent. Emotic ancestry in Northeast Africa generally seems to peak among the Aili of southwestern Ethiopia, gradually lessening the further away an individual is from there. The Niger-Congo component, which is another way of saying West African and Bantu, has appeared on other DNA tests I've done and in other calculators on GEDmatch, so I don't doubt it. However, depending on the calculator or DNA test I used, it ranges from 5% to 10%. The Khoisan ancestry might just be noise due to how low it is, or it might be true since it is believed the Khoisan inhabited large parts of East Africa in the distant past. These should be taken as estimates, but the most important components to me are the Nilotic and Emotic ones since they make up my East African ancestry. In regard to my Middle Eastern ancestry, I do not really have an interest about what specific people it comes from, although it is generally believed to come from a Levantine, Anatolian, and or an Iranian source. The Middle Eastern component is harder to pinpoint than the African one due to its ancient nature and the population movements and replacements that occurred in the Middle East over thousands of years. There is also Oracle that appears alongside your results, which is similar to the genetically closest populations tools on Illustrative DNA. Depending on which calculator I use, the top results changes, some of which are Afar, Amhara, or Tigrayan, which are close estimates since they are genetically related and live closer to Guinea people. GenMatch has numerous calculators, and if you do not have some knowledge about your own people's history and genetics and how the calculators come to its results, you will misinterpret some of the results. Some of the calculators include spreadsheets which shows the results of certain ethnicities and nationalities to help you understand what each genetic ancestry component means. Honestly, if Illustrative DNA separated the Nilo-Saharan ancestry from the Emotic ancestry, I would not really have a reason for doing GenMatch, since Illustrative DNA overall gives a better user experience, which is updated frequently, more informative, and much easier to understand. The GenMatch calculators don't seem to be updated frequently, and the numerous calculators makes one question which is reliable or not, since they give different results. GenMatch is still a decent alternative to Illustrative DNA, especially since it is free. However, if you are willing to pay, Illustrative DNA is worth it instead. If you decide to use GenMatch, the calculators I've shown are the best for Horan Africans, in my opinion.